Welcome to this tutorial on the coating log program. It logs data from this coating machine, such as web speed and web distance. And also when you are slot die coating, it calculates the wet thickness from the pump rate and the coating width. This, together with your own comments, are shown graphically for an easy overview of your coating and printing run. These data are invaluable for ensuring that you document important knowledge and improve repeatability as well as increasing your productivity. Before we go into the program, I'll show you how to set up the connection between the TR2RC and the computer. The USB connector is placed on the back side of the TR2RC machine here, and the cable then connects to the PC, which is placed outside the fume cupboard in a safe distance to avoid contamination with inks and so on.
Let us start the coating log program. First, you have to select the correct COM port for communicating with the TR2RC unit. In this case, it's COM12. We'll now explore the program interface. At the top, we have the menu, as usual, where we can choose between, say, a new coating log, open a previously saved coating log, or save the present coating log, and also exiting the program. Below that, we have a coating info window, where we can write what kind of coating run we are doing today. Let's say that we are slot die coating an active ink. Let's put that in. Okay. Then we can choose between either slot die coating or flexo printing. And right now we of course slot die coating, so the syringe pump area over here is active. If we press the flexo printing, then the flexo unit area over here will become active. We press the slot die coating and we can then put in the pump rate that we will be using in this slot die coating experiment here. Let's say that that is 1 milliliters per minute and that we will coat at a width of 80 millimeters. We'll now start the TR2RC unit. This is indicated by a comment down here in the comment list. We started at 0 meters at 1.6 minutes, counterclockwise at 1.3 meters per minute. And we can also see that we have two traces in this graph window, a red trace for the web speed and a green trace for the wet thickness. The wet thickness is also calculated and shown in the syringe pump area here, where we can see that it is now 9 micrometers thick. We'll now try and increase the speed of the TR2RC. We're now running at 2.75 meters per minute. And you can see that the speed, web speed trace here increased, while the wet thickness decreased now to 4 micrometers per minute. If something happens during the run, we can add a comment. Let's say that we had a some kind of coating error, and we want to report that. So we write here, coating error, and it may have happened at, say, 3.2 minutes. This will then be indicated by a marker and a line, and also an entry in the coating list here. We'll now stop the TR2RC and say that this coating run is over. This is now indicated by another blue marker here and an entry in the comment list. So we stopped after 4.6 meters and we're now ready to save our first coating log.
Well, I hope that you can get started with the coating log program together with the TR2RC and increase your productivity.